There comes a time when the useful life of an offshore oil and gas platform ends, at least when it comes to drilling for oil. That's when I dive in. As a marine scientist building the bridge between energy and the environment, I work with offshore energy companies to help them repurpose their derelict oil rigs into permanent artificial reefs. There are over 600 rig-to-reef conversions worldwide, capitalizing on and preserving the unique marine ecosystems that have developed on these structures over time. But how do we know if these ecosystems are truly valuable? And honestly, how do we study anything in the oceans? It's one of the most unpredictable, volatile environments to work in. There's a reason it's been said that we know more about the surface of the moon. Space just seems so much easier. But times are changing. Today, we're leveraging the power of technology to explore our oceans at new depths and understand marine life and the environment in ways we never have before. With tools like underwater drones, satellites, and virtual reality, technology is driving innovation in ocean exploration and expanding our ability to better understand and protect our oceans. But before I get into all of this, let me back up to how I got here. As a Laguna Beach native, I grew up jumping through the blowhole at Pearl Street Beach or just trying to avoid a sunburn at Anita. And I remember one summer looking out on the horizon. It was one of those particularly clear days where you can see way past Catalina. And I caught a glimpse of what looked to me at the time to be these massive ocean robots that had obviously crossed the Pacific to invade California. Of course, this was quite an exaggerated version of reality. They were just the offshore oil and gas platforms off of Long Beach, not ocean robots. Fast forward 15 years, and I'm in graduate school researching these platforms, not as industrial giants, but for the booming ecosystems that have developed on these structures, providing acres of habitat and a permanent home for thousands of fish. In California, scientists have found that our offshore oil and gas platforms are some of the most productive habitats on the planet, more productive than mangroves and coral reefs. Pause and let that sink in. There are habitats on California's offshore oil and gas platforms that are some of the most productive habitats globally. For me, as a scientist, it all began when I got scuba certified. A new world opened up to me. But as a diver, you're limited by depth, and for my work on these oil platforms, I need to go deeper. To do this, I use a remotely operated vehicle, or ROV. I've worked with several of these underwater drones to explore our oceans at depths as shallow as 20 feet to as deep as 7,000 feet. This technology is only getting better. With grabber claws to take samples, laser scalers to size fish underwater, and video enhancements, we are literally seeing things we've never had the capacity to before. Over the past decade, ROVs have been used to explore our oceans in new ways. We've not only mapped the Titanic shipwreck, but we've sampled deep sea sponges and sediments that are answering medical questions that have puzzled us for years around cancer treatment and pain management. And we're only getting started. Now I want to zoom back out to space, but this time I want to talk about satellites. Organizations like Global Fishing Watch are using satellites to track fishing behavior in our oceans. The same way you can track your kid via their cell phone, they're tracking fishing vessels, even off-grid illegal vessels, using satellites. But is this kind of big brother behavior really the answer? Is it good for the ocean? Good for us? Let me give you an example using a squid. Squid fishermen use extreme lights on their boats to draw in their catch. These lights are so bright that they can actually be seen and tracked from space. Using satellites over the past several years, we've found that while squid fishing has remained stagnant in regulated areas, it's grown exponentially in unregulated waters. Today, 86% of squid fishing globally is taking place in unregulated waters. Satellites have enabled us to observe this illicit fishing behavior and better deploy enforcement to ensure compliance with catch limits and seasonal closures. And more squid in the ocean means a healthier ocean overall. Health in the ocean means health for us. And when I say us, I don't just mean us, the lucky Laguna locals. The oceans are for everyone. Whether you're a farmer in Iowa or a surfer in California, the oceans impact all of us. But it doesn't always feel that way, and a farmer in Iowa might not care at all about the ocean. Yet we need them to care. So how do we reach that person? Technological advancements in virtual reality, or VR, and experimental learning are breaking down the barriers that used to surround equitable access to our oceans. Today, through the eyes of a VR headset or a VR video game, anyone with access to this gear can take a virtual dive along a coral reef, or even along an oil platform reef, without ever getting wet. This technology is especially impactful in the hands of children. The addition of VR in classrooms and in museums is enabling and inspiring the next generation of ocean explorers, creating pathways for all to be leaders in the ocean conservation space, like Jacques Cousteau or Sylvia Earle. Technology is changing the future of ocean conservation for the better. In a world where we're constantly being inundated by the hard realities of our declining, our bleaching, our overfished oceans, we're also learning more, discovering cures, protecting our limited resources better, and seeing more people from a diversity of backgrounds getting involved and caring for our oceans. Now, more than ever before, technology has played an important part in this and should give all of us just a little bit of hope for the future of our oceans. Thank you.